Welcome to the Tough Decisions Network for Entrepreneurs. I'm Dan Handford, and my wife, Dennae, and I interview successful people sharing stories behind tough decisions that they've had to make along their journey as an entrepreneur.
On the podcast with us today is Daniel Ghelman. Daniel, thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Go ahead and start us off by just telling us a little bit about your background as an entrepreneur and where your current focus is.
Perfect. So I'm one of the co-founders of LifeKee. LifeKee is a dynamic contact and identity management platform, both for individuals and organizations, where each one updates their own information on behalf of everyone else they're connected with. My current focus is sales and marketing. I'm one of three co-founders. It's a startup, so all three of us wear many hats. You know how that goes. Before this, I worked in Brightstar, I worked in GMED, I worked Motorola. So I come actually from the corporate world, and this is my first true entrepreneurial experience. Although I've been always a little bit of an intrapreneur, if you will. I was truly an entrepreneur, creating new divisions in the companies I worked with, being in the new business development side. So always trying to find innovation. I used to joke around that at some point in time, I was the director of dual temperatures, what's hot and what's cool.
That's a good way to look at it. Well, I know you've probably along this journey, even though, you know, being in the entrepreneur side of things might not be as long as your, you know, intrapreneur side of things, but talk to us about a tough decision that you've had to make as an entrepreneur that didn't have that good of an outcome. I like to call it the sore thumb tough decision and some of the lessons you learned through it.
I think the toughest decision I've made as an entrepreneur is we outsourced a highly reputable software development firm because we decided that at that point made sense to outsource our engineering as opposed to bring it in-house because of the cash we had at that point. They had great references, they had good pedigree, and we wanted them to work on our mobile app and the corporate platform. We knew that they were expensive, more than what we wanted to pay, but we decided it was well worth it. And the second mistake was actually taking too long to fire them. It took us a while to realize that the work they were doing did not meet our requirements and needs. It took a lot longer than it should have, and we wasted both time and money. So I think that was a sore thumb decision.
What's a different type of tough decision that you've had to face that had a really good and positive outcome and some of the lessons you learned through that one?
Okay, so one within LifeKee, I think deciding to leave my posh corporate job and my 15 and 30 checks to join a team of two great co-founders and launch LifeKee, it was a really tough decision. As I said, I had been a corporate animal for many, many years, and it's comforting to receive your paycheck, knowing that you're doing your job, but it's been the most rewarding and challenging period of my professional career, and I'm looking forward to what the future may come and may bring with LifeKee.
So Daniel, talk a little bit more about maybe some of the things, the factors that went into that decision. And did you know right away that that was going to be a good decision, or was there a time period where you may have doubted? And how did you know that that was the time? What were some of the things that were kind of going through your mind and playing into that decision?
I've had to make tough decisions like this in my life previous to this entrepreneurial life. Another really good one that is comparable to this was to decide to accept an offer to be director of Motorola in Japan for 2 years. My family moved with me from Venezuela. We were here in the US. We were fine. My extended family moved here. And leaving our family and friends in Miami was very tough, especially as it was so far away. But I think we would make the same decision today. And the reason why I'm bringing it up is because it's always a decision of leaving the comfortable pier or the comfortable land where you're used to everything that's happening will happen tomorrow similarly, and you know what to expect, and jumping into the unexpected. So when did I think that it was the right decision? I think I had a really good feeling the moment I made the decision, and it took me several weeks of talking with my wife and consulting with myself and, you know, trying to go in depth in the decision. But once I made the decision, I felt so enthralled of having made it that I knew it was the right decision. And yes, you question it every now and then and you say, wow, if I were still employed, what would it look like? But I know that every time I think about that, it's like, no, no, this was the right decision.
What are some of the strategies that you use when you are facing a difficult decision?
I exercise. Sometimes I go for a bike ride. Fortunately, here in Florida, you can all do that almost every day of the year. Or I just go for a quick run. I always sleep on it. I never made an important decision in the heat of the moment. And I, quote unquote, wait for the sand to drop. This is a good learning my mother actually taught me. Imagine if you have a little bottle full of water with a little bit of sand. When you're going to make a decision, shake that bottle really hard. And until all the sand has dropped to the bottom, don't make a decision. And just, it's a good metaphor for don't make decisions in the heat of the moment. As an entrepreneur, you need to make constantly decisions, but everything can be slept on.
That's so true. A lot of times we trick ourselves or we let other people trick us into thinking that we have to make a decision right away. And there's just so few times where it actually has to be made in the moment. Like you said, almost always you can at least sleep on it one night before making that decision. I think that is a really good strategy to practice.
Talking with other people helps me too. My wife, I think she's my best friend, and she's a very smart lady, and we can sit down and talk about things, and she'll always have a different spin on it and a different perspective. And that always grounds me and say, oh, okay, I guess I didn't look at it from this perspective. So talking with other people always helps, having someone to be a sounding board.
We're going to take a quick break and hear from one of our show sponsors. When we come back, we'll talk to Daniel about some of his favorites as it relates to his life as an entrepreneur.
Have you ever thought about investing in real estate, but find yourself so busy that you don't have time for it? Do you have FOMO, which is the fear of missing out? At HanfordCapital.com, we help investors with passive real estate investments that project better returns than traditional investment vehicles such as the stock market. If you'd like to find out more about our passive real estate investments, visit HanfordCapital.com. That's HANFORD Capital.com. We will jump on a call with you to discuss your investment goals and to see if our investments are a good fit for you. This advertisement is not to be construed as an offer or recommendation to buy or sell a security. Visit HanfordCapital.com.
And we are back with Daniel Ghelman. Daniel, I want you to start us with a series of quick questions and answers that we call the trifecta with your favorite technology that you use in business that helps make your life easier every day.
I'm in sales and marketing, so I'm going to have to say WhatsApp actually is one of my favorite technologies. I use WhatsApp constantly to communicate with our customers, particularly the ones in Latin America, both via text and via video. We send attachments through WhatsApp, pictures through WhatsApp. So it's a simple yet very effective tool.
What is a favorite quote that you've heard that has helped you as an entrepreneur?
I think one of my favorite ones is in Japanese, and it says, "Sanity no michi mo ippo kara," and it means even a road of 1,000 miles begin with a single step.
And what is a favorite book that you've read that's helped you make better decisions as an entrepreneur?
I have a couple of books. The Lean Startup by Eric Ries is a must read. And The Tipping Point by Malcolm Gladwell is very eye-opening.
What's the next thing for you right now on your vision or dream board?
So we need to expand LifeKee. We need to execute very well on the customers we have signed and continue signing new customers to make sure that this is the success we all envision.
And how can the listeners reach out to you if they have questions or want to follow you more, or maybe even download the app that you have?
Absolutely. The easiest way is to download the app. My life key is Dan135.
Dan135.
That's correct.
Great. And we'll make sure we have all the references there and the links to everything on our show notes, which can be found at toughdecisions.net. I want to thank you, Daniel, for coming onto our podcast today and sharing your insights. We look forward to continuing to follow you as an entrepreneur and possibly having you on as a future guest.
Thank you, Dan. Thank you, Dennae.
Thank you for listening to the Tough Decisions Network. Be sure to visit toughdecisions.net to gain access to show notes for this episode and to join our free weekly entrepreneur email, where we will send you news about the latest technology for your business, inspiring quotes, and the latest books for entrepreneurs. That's toughdecisions.net.